Alexa, open Oprah magazine.
Welcome back to Oprah magazine. Would you like to replay today's O2Go?
Yes.
Here's today's O2Go from Oprah's column, What I Know for Sure.
My biggest mistakes in life have all stemmed from giving my power to someone else, believing that the love others had to offer was more important than the love I had to give to myself. I remember being 29 and in a relationship based on lies and deceit, down on my knees, crying after Mr. Man, who we shall not name here, once again had brought me low. I'd been waiting for him all evening. He stood me up, and it wasn't the first time. He arrived hours after our date was supposed to start, and I dared to ask why. I remember him standing in the doorway and hurling these words at me. The problem with you, baby doll, is that you think you're special. At which point, he turned on his heels and slammed the door in my face. I'd grown up watching my cousin Alice be physically abused by her boyfriend, and I vowed I would never take such treatment. But sitting there on the bathroom floor, after Mr. Man walked out, I saw with great clarity the only difference between Alice and me was that I hadn't been hit. Mr. Mann was wrong. I did not think I was special, and that was the problem. Why was I allowing myself to be treated this way? Even with these insights, it took me another year to end the relationship. I kept hoping and praying that things would get better, that he would change. He never did. I started praying for the strength to just end it. I'd pray and wait to feel better and wait, all the while repeating my same old patterns. Until one day, I got it. While I was waiting on God, God was waiting on me. He was waiting on me to make a decision to either pursue the life that was meant for me or to be stifled by the one I was living. I recognized the truth that I'm all right. Just as I am, I am enough, all by myself. That revelation brought its own miracle. Around that time, the call came for me to audition for a talk show in Chicago. If I had stayed entangled in that relationship, my life as I know it would never have happened. What is the truth of your life? It is your duty to know. In order to find out, know that the truth is that which feels right and good and loving. Love doesn't hurt, I've learned in the years since I was 29. It feels really good. It's that which allows you to live every day with integrity. Everything you do and say shows the world who you are. Let it be the truth.
That's all from O2Go for today. Check in tomorrow for your next dose of inspiration. Or you can hear more by purchasing the What I Know for Sure audiobook CD. Just say, order Oprah's audiobook CD.